friends, welcome to Crisp class. I am Monica and today we will study data handling. We have already studied about data. We collect information in the form of figures. Each figure is called an observation. So the collection of all these observations is called data. This we have done earlier. Now see, we have been given this data. These are the marks of 5 students. We have to represent them on the bar graph. So let us see how we will make the bar graph for it. First, we will make the 2 axes. This is the x axis and this is the y axis. We will take equal divisions on the x axis. Here we will write the names of the students. So here on the horizontal line, which is the x-axis, we have written the names of the students. See, this I am making a rough figure. You have to make all the lines with your ruler. Now we will mark the markings on the y-axis. Here, this is the 0 point. See here, we have to make equal divisions. These divisions have to be of equal distance. Distance between each division should be same. We are starting with 0. Now see, the end point, the end marking of this scale has to be a number which is bigger than the maximum marks obtained by the student. The maximum marks here is 540. So we can take a number which is close to 540. It can be 600. So, and then we will take the unit in according to that. Here we are taking the unit 100. One unit is equal to 100. Here you will mention the scale. One unit is equal to 100 marks. This is very important to be mentioned. So there will be equal increments between all the divisions. This is 100. This will be 200, 300, 400, 500, 600. So what we have to do, we have to choose the unit so that the length of this scale is appropriate, so that the bars are not too long or too short. So here we are taking the unit as 100. If we take the unit as 10, it won't fit into our space. The length of this scale will exceed. Now see, we will plot the marks. Ajay has got 450 marks. So what we will do is, 450 means it will lie between 400 and 500. See, you have a graph paper. This is a rough representation. You will be having graph papers where there will be boxes. Squares will be there and it would be easy for you to plot the marks. Here I am taking a number 450 as the center. This is somewhere here. In the center of 400 and 500. Now I will make a bar like this. So this bar, it is representing Ajay's marks. The height of the bar will represent the marks of Ajay. The bar is ending at 450. So we can see that Ajay's marks, how many marks did Ajay get? 450 marks. Similarly, we will make bars for other students. Bali has got 500. So 500 will be like this. Now we have to remember that the width of each bar has to be equal. This width should be same throughout. It will not change. Dipti got 300. So 300 will be here. Geeta has got 400. and Hari has got 540. Now see, Hari has got 540. Between 500 and 600 in the center we will have somewhere here 550, and 540 will be a little below it, somewhat here. You have to make straight lines. These are just rough representation which I am showing you. So this is Hari's marks, which are 540. And you have to remember that the space between the bars has to be same. It won't change. The space which you take between the mark, these two bars, bars of Ajay and Pali's marks, has to be same between all these bars. So this is how we have represented this data on the bar graph. Here we will write marks. These are the marks of the students, and there on the x-axis we have the names of the students. Now we will study about double bar graph. See, what is a double bar graph? When we plot two datas on the same graph, it is called double bar graph. We are given a question. These are the marks obtained by 5 students in quarterly exams and in half yearly exams. In both the exams, the marks are out of 25. We have to plot these on the graph. Now let us start. We will make the two axes. This is the horizontal line, x-axis, vertical line, y-axis. Now on the x-axis, horizontal line, we will write the names of the students. So we have written the names of the students. Now we will mark the scale on the y-axis. The scale will start with 0. Now the maximum limit, maximum number which we have to write on the scale should be a little greater than the greatest number here. So we can take it to 25. We will write 25 as the top number here. Let us take divisions of 5. 1 unit is equal to 5. So what is the 1 unit? The scale we have taken, it is 5 marks. We will write the unit on this side. These are the marks. Now we will plot both the datas one by one on the graph paper. See, first we will plot the quarterly marks. Ashish has scored 10 marks. So here we will make a thin bar which will represent the marks of Ashish. Then comes Arun marks. This is, he has scored 15 out of 25. Kavish has scored 12. 12 will be, see, this is the center point. So 12 will be somewhat here. You have to make straight lines with your ruler. This is only the rough representation. Maya has scored 20. And Rita has scored 9 marks. 9 will be a little below 10. The distance between the bars is not same. This is just only a rough representation. There you have to keep the distance between the bars equal, and the width of the bars also has to be equal. Now see, this we have plotted. Quarterly marks we have plotted on the graph. Now here we have to write that this bar, it represents quarterly marks. The another data we have, which we have to plot on it, the either the color of the bar should be different or the pattern should be different, so that we can differentiate between the two datas. Here we will now plot the half yearly exams of Ashish. It is 15. So 15 is here. We will join these bars together like this and make a different pattern in this bar, so that we can distinguish both the data. This is quarterly one, this is half yearly. Here we have to mention also that which bar is for which data. Now Arun has scored 18 . We will make a bar here and make the pattern on it. Kavish has scored 16. A little above 15 will be 16. Make it like this. Now Maya has scored 21. So it will be a little above this. This is our bar. Preeta has scored 15 marks. There is a commendable improvement in Preeta's marks. See. So this is how we have shown both the datas. So we can easily differentiate both the data. This double bar graph, it helps us to compare both datas easily. This graph is showing a commendable improvement in all the students. Now see, in double bar graphs, it is very necessary to mention this, that which bar is representing which data. And the bar should be of different color or of different pattern. So now we know what are bar graphs. Bar graphs are the representation of data in the form of bars on a graph. Those are called bar graphs. And when we plot two data on the same graph, they are called double bar graphs.